It's AumSum time.
Hi guys, can you guess the title of my next video?
Huh?
Hurry up! Write your guess in the comment section below.
Why is it hard to cure Alzheimer's disease? Alzheimer's disease is an irreversible progressive brain disorder. It basically occurs when proteins in the brain malfunction and clump together, forming plaques and tangles. These plaques and tangles block communication in between brain cells and even cause cell death, thus leading to memory loss, mood changes, hallucinations, etc. Now, it is hard to cure Alzheimer's because symptoms of the disease begin to show when it has almost irreversibly damaged the brain. Also, finding candidates for effective clinical trials is difficult because there is no method to identify people with the disease at initial stages. Thus, it is hard to test the medications and check whether they work or not. In addition to this, Alzheimer's affects different people in different ways. Hence, a drug which is somewhat effective on a patient suffering from Alzheimer's might not work on another patient. In short, due to a lack of fundamental understanding of the disease, we are unable to cure Alzheimer's. What causes body odor?
Duh! Obviously sweat.
No.
Sweat
is odorless.
Oh.
What? But how is that possible?
Our skin contains two types of sweat glands. Eccrine glands and apocrine glands. Eccrine glands are present all over our body. They produce sweat, which is mostly water. Whereas apocrine glands are concentrated in regions such as ear canals, armpits, etc. They produce thicker sweat, which has proteins.
Can I eat these proteins and become a bodybuilder?
Oh, gross. Just listen. We know that millions of bacteria are normally found all over our skin. When apocrine glands produce sweat, the bacteria on our skin break down the proteins in that sweat, releasing unpleasant smell, which we call as body odor. How to not cry while cutting onions?
Watch a comedy movie!
Nah. When we cut onions, chemicals like sulfoxides and enzymes are released which react to eventually form a gas. This gas reacts with the lubricating liquid in our eyes and produces sulfuric acid, which makes us cry. However, if we freeze onions before cutting, then the temperature of onions drops. Due to this, the sulfoxides and enzymes react slowly, producing less gas and thus reducing the amount of crying. We can even wear tight goggles so that the gas doesn't reach our eyes. It is also said that below the onion roots, there's a bulb where the concentration of chemicals is more. Hence, to avoid crying, we should first cut and throw that part. Also, cutting an onion under running water washes away the chemicals. Hence, we can also use this method to reduce crying while cutting onions. What is vocal fry?
It may be similar to a French fry.
Not at all. Vocal fry is a creaky or raspy voice seldom used in speech.
I thought it is used by leech.
Oh, gross. Just throw that away and listen. When we speak, air from our lungs passes through the vocal folds, making them vibrate. These vibrations make the air in our mouth and nose to vibrate, thus producing sound or voice. Generally, human voice can be divided into three ranges or registers. They are falsetto, modal, and fry. Most people speak and sing in the modal range. But sometimes, when we speak in fry range, our vocal folds slam shut. However, longitudinally, they are not stretched tightly. Air from the lungs bubbles out through this loosely closed fold, thus creating that creaky voice called fry. Topic: pressure. Why is it difficult to cut with a blunt knife? Seems like you are hungry. Huh? Why didn't you have an apple?
Oh.
Hooray!
No, don't use the blunt knife. Use the sharp knife. Looks like you want to go ahead with the blunt knife only. See? Huh? You are finding it difficult to cut the apple now. Now, try cutting with the sharp knife.
Hooray!
Look, the apple gets cut very easily. Confused, right? Let me explain. All this happens due to a concept called pressure. What is pressure? It is the force applied per unit area. That means the pressure will be directly proportional to force and inversely proportional to area. Now, we applied the same amount of force on both the knives. Then, why was the result different? This is because the area on which the force acted was different. In the case of a blunt knife, the cutting edge is thicker. That means the area is larger. As a result, the force of our hand falls over a larger area of the knife, producing less pressure. Hence, it is difficult to cut with a blunt knife.